Welcome back, folks. And now I have Erin joining me from Red Buffalo Coffee and Tea. Erin, how you doing this beautiful morning?
Thank you. I know it's supposed to be hot today.
Well, I think...
It's like Colorado weather, right? So let's not go too far into this. Chance of mixed precipitation is always...
Well, it's a high of 77, which I can't believe I'm saying this, is actually cooler than some of the past days that we've had. We've had highs in the 80s,
so
it's like, oh, it's only 77. Right. We're like normally up here, we're like melting at 75.
Right. But this weekend it was like rain showers.
Yeah.
Like, this is nice.
Yeah.
But I had my mother-in-law visiting from Grand Junction because she was too hot.
Yeah.
And so she came to town to be colder, and she's like, but it's 50 degrees in the morning. It's too cold.
Was she wearing a puffy?
She was.
Yeah. I wear puffies up here too. I mean,
well, it's morning weather. You have to bring layers.
And then the evening as well.
Yeah. It's like coffee. I layer my coffee consumption through the day. We start hot. We start with like a nice hot coffee or a latte.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, midday we have a tea. And then afternoon we've moved on to iced beverages.
Now, what kind of tea do you have midday? What kind of iced beverages? Like, tell us the specifics, the details. Does it change every day?
So my hot tea middle of the day is usually like a green or a black. Mm-hmm. And I usually just go like a straight tea. We have great options that are like blended with some fruits and some other great flavors, but I really just like a straight black tea or a straight green tea.
Mm-hmm.
But then by afternoon, I moved on to like our iced tea spritzer, which is iced tea, club soda, lemonade, and raspberry. So the proportion of tea is less. So the amount of caffeine I'm getting at like 3 in the afternoon is less than the amount of caffeine I consumed earlier in the day. But I'm still getting like a little kick.
So it's just kind of like weaning you off and kind of getting you ready.
Exactly. So I wean the caffeine dependence through the day as well as the temperature difference.
Mm-hmm.
So it's an art. So it's layering.
So as you know, I'm a big fan of decaf.
Yes.
So I start with decaf and then the middle of the day I get my half calf.
Well, you can't just, but like for some people, you can't just like hit the ground running.
Right.
You need to trot first, you need to stretch.
And everybody's different.
Some sun salutations.
Everybody reacts to caffeine differently.
They
so you got to find the routine that works for you.
And we have some great decaf as well, because a lot of people go like,
decaf,
why bother?
No, but you guys do.
There's a point for decaf, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Like if it's 8 o'clock at night and I still want a coffee for some reason.
Yeah, especially like after a big, delicious meal, you kind of want that espresso to kind of...
You do. Or if you've been to like our neighbor, the Lake Dillon Theater, and you're like, you get home at night and you think like, I really want a coffee.
Yeah.
But that wouldn't be a good idea at 8 o'clock at night.
No, not a good idea.
Yeah. But our decafs are our Swiss water processed decaf. So they don't really have that dry chemically taste that a lot of regular decafs do. So you can come in and still got a full body, got all those oils and taste to it.
Yeah. No, I know my parents in Chicago, they're big fans of decaf and they love yours because it's hard to find a good one.
It is.
And I think in general also, it's like you guys put so much care towards just like the roasting and everything. And I know in past shows you talked about how the altitude, there's a difference of how, you know, with the water boiling and everything, that the coffee really needs to be roasted a certain way to kind of work with us. And I was thinking about that the other weekend. I was backpacking, and we always talk about coffee. You need it camping.
Yes.
And, you know, there's people coming up here. They've got their coffee for their camping, and it's probably not tasting as good as what they're used to.
Yeah. So if you brought your coffee from somewhere else, or you're even just brewing for the first time at this altitude, or even higher up, if you go into some of our higher alpine lakes, it's like 12, 13,000 feet. And you have to adjust your coffee ratios because your water is colder, especially the higher and higher and higher you go up.
Mm-hmm.
And so you do have to like, all right, well, it's not tasting how I want to. And, you know, before you start getting caring about the science at 6 a.m, maybe just try playing with your ratio, maybe using a little bit more, maybe using a little bit less.
Mm-hmm.
Because especially if you've already gone to the effort of hiking up there, you probably haven't brought a hand grinder.
Yeah.
Fun hand grinders you can bring backpacking.
Have you done that?
Yes. So these little hand burr grinders, because burr grinders are so much better than blade grinders, but most of us pre-grind our coffee before we go camping.
Yes.
So you can't change the variable of your water temperature. You can't change the variable of your grind size, because grind size can change how quickly your coffee will brew.
Yeah.
But you can change how much coffee you use, your ratio of water to coffee.
Okay.
So if your first batch tastes a little funny, because hopefully you brought enough to make, you know, 2 or 3 batches of coffee.
Yeah.
Because you need the first coffee and then the second coffee.
Yeah.
Try adjusting that ratio. Try maybe a little bit more or a little bit less. And so those are like, you can control only so many variables at a time. So if you're backpacking and your only variable you can control is your water to coffee ratio, use a little bit more coffee.
Yeah.
Use a little bit less coffee.
And if people need more coffee advice, of course, they can come into Red Buffalo Coffee and Tea and talk to you and find out all your tips and tricks.
Absolutely. And, you know, we're just a quarter mile north of the I-70 Silverthorne Interstate exit in Silverthorne. So it's just central to anything you're doing. Silverthorne's really your jumping off point for all of your Summit County adventures.
Yeah, pretty much. It's like right there. It's like the X. You go in any direction.
X marks the spot. This is where you get off of the interstate. And we're right next to the Lake Dillon Theater. Mm-hmm. We're right next to some great restaurants, the Silverthorne Pavilion. If you brought your kiddos, we're literally across the river from Rainbow Park, which I know when I bring my son to the park, it's like, I could use a coffee while I'm sitting here.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Erin, thank you so much for joining us.
Of course.
As always, great to chat with you.
Oh, so much fun.
So, folks, be sure to go on into Red Buffalo Coffee and Tea, get yourself a beverage, and, of course, get some tips and tricks for your coffee and tea up here in High Country.